Today, watching PTS English News, I'm Ethan Lil. As the pandemic situation is getting worse, the Ministry of Health and Welfare has decided to allow children aged 6 to 11 to get the Moderna vaccine. Meanwhile, a fourth shot is also recommended for vulnerable groups.
Clara Zhou hosted her radio program as usual on April 20th. She interviewed Advisory Committee on Immunization Practices convener Li Binging. The two shared a studio during the live broadcast. One day later, Zhou posted on Facebook that she had tested positive in a PCR test. Although both were wearing masks the entire time, Li still took a PCR test. Li attended an ACIP meeting on April 20th. He said all participants wore masks the entire time. The committee decided to allow the use of the Moderna vaccine on children aged 6 to 11 and people in high-risk groups, including senior citizens, residents of long-term care facilities, and immunosuppressed adults to get a fourth shot. Some experts say COVID-19 will spread even faster in October and November when the weather cools, and even the average person may need to get four shots. Meanwhile, one Academia Sinica academician called for the research and development of a broad-spectrum vaccine that can protect against all future variants.
继转之后，大家也知道，必须要经过一级、二级、三级人体试验，然后证明它的安全性跟有效性。那之后，经过卫生单位的核准才能使用。所以这个需要一段时间。Experts
say the daily caseload may exceed 10,000 by the end of April or the beginning of May, based on how quickly the disease is spreading and the RT value. They recommend suspending epidemic investigations to ensure that medical treatment is being used effectively.
20% of Taiwan's population will contract COVID-19 in the future, according to Taipei Deputy Mayor Vivian Huang. CCC Commander Chen Shizhong said he's hoping to keep the rate to around 15%.
The domestic epidemic is heating up as the number of confirmed cases has exceeded 1,000 for six consecutive days. The number of cases soared to more than 2,000 on the 20th. At present, medical personnel can have their home isolation duration shortened and return to work as long as their daily PCR or rapid test results are negative. The pilots' union also sent a letter to the Central Epidemic Command Center, hoping to receive the same loosened restrictions. CECC Commander Chen Shizhong said in the legislative yuan on the 21st that discussions are still ongoing for applicable occupations that will be exempted from home isolation. But the prerequisite is that people in these occupations must have received three doses of the vaccine. Implementation procedures will also change depending on the epidemic situation.
我想那个都会整体来讨论，那筛检代替隔离，这个政策方向是确定的，只是实施的一个程序要视疫情的一个变化。The
public is actively vaccinating as the domestic epidemic situation has raised alarms. Some counties and cities are worried that vaccine inventory is not enough. Chen said that two shipments of the Moderna vaccine will arrive in the near future. Taipei Deputy Mayor Vivian Huang pointed out that the future estimated infection rate is 20%, meaning one in five Taiwanese people will contract the virus. Chen responded by saying this is not impossible.
20%不是不可能的，但我们希望能够压在大概15-16这样的一个比例。
As the number of confirmed cases in Taiwan has greatly increased, so has demand for rapid screening tests. Some people reported they could not buy test kits at pharmacies. Chen said that it is now easier to buy in convenience stores. Pharmacies are still actively negotiating purchase methods. The cost will also be different in the future as the real name registration system will be implemented.
The Taichung City government confirmed it is running out of the Moderna vaccine. Many people rushed to get shots as a result.
Many people rushed to Taichung vaccination sites on April 21st, hoping to get Moderna vaccines before the city supply runs out. However, all the available vaccines were already accounted for. This, plus the worsening epidemic situation and the requirement that workers in certain venues need to get third doses before April 22nd, resulted in brisk business at vaccination sites. At Taichung's Wenxing Forest Park vaccination site, numbers for people wishing to get the Moderna vaccine were distributed starting at 9 a.m. and none were left by
9:30 a.m.
Taichung's Health Bureau announced on April 20th that 5 vaccination sites will stop offering vaccination services, and there were reports that people had their vaccine bookings at medical institutions canceled. The Bureau said the city only has 50,000 Moderna doses left. It is currently administering 10,000 to 20,000 a day, which means it will run out by April 24th.
4月25号到5月1号这一周，如果中央疫苗还没有下来的话， 还没有办法拨补的话，我们要暂停施打莫德纳疫苗。
Doctors say people have many considerations for deciding which vaccine to get, and the Moderna and BNT vaccines both have supporters and detractors. People should make rational decisions.
之前那个莫德纳那个供应量很充足的时候，民众都是在担心它的副作用，哦，一直要找 BNT。 BNT很充足的时候，民众又觉得说，哎，莫德纳的效果比较好。但是现在如果说，莫德纳暂时青黄不接的情况下，还是建议说有什么就赶快打什么。The
Bureau said the city still has 26,000 Medigen vaccines and 1,500 AZ vaccines, which will be available next week. People who need to travel abroad are advised to get the AZ vaccine, while those worried about side effects should get Medigen.
A new Taipei elementary school went to Orchid Island for outdoor teaching, only to find out that 2 of the students were diagnosed with COVID-19.
108 teachers and students from this new Taipei City elementary school went to Orchid Island for outdoor teaching. It was reported that a student needed to self-isolate just after they arrived. A teacher escorted the student back to New Taipei on the 19th, and the student was later confirmed with the virus. Another student tested positive with a PCR test on the island on the 20th, and the principal accompanied the student to quarantine on the island. The school quickly chartered a boat to take the remaining 104 teachers and students back to Taichung on the 21st, and they immediately boarded buses back to Taipei. The school emphasized that all teachers and students were negative using quick screening tests before departure, and epidemic prevention measures were also taken on Orchid Island. Therefore, the entire epidemic prevention process was in accordance with government regulations.
我们全校老师跟家长在吃饭、行动、住房、坐车，还有我们玩的方式，我们没有一个环节漏掉该做防疫措施。
The number of confirmed cases has remained high for the past few days, and many local governments have called on schools to cancel or postpone cross-regional activities. However, this new Taipei primary school still went to Orchid Island as planned. The school repeatedly emphasized that it prepared an epidemic prevention plan before departure, but students still contracted the virus. Now, 3 BMBs on the island are all on high alert.
最重要一点是我们让老师、学生跟小朋友都知道要怎么防疫。那你目前就是说比较有可能接触到的话，是有三家民宿吧，好，然后还有那相关的工作人员，那我们都已经发给他快筛剂，而筛检结果都是阴性。
The Taichung Health Bureau stated that it is currently coordinating with the central government on how to bring the diagnosed student who quarantined on the island and the accompanying principal back to Taiwan proper to avoid causing medical pressures on Orchid Island. The Orchid Island Township Office will also convene hotel operators on the 22nd to discuss whether to continue receiving tourists to the island.
Now, a few more stories from around Taiwan. Taipei City Hospital Deputy Superintendent Huang Hongmeng was diagnosed with COVID-19 on the 20th, one day after he visited the Taipei City Council, whose offices underwent disinfections upon learning the news. As the nationwide home care program is gradually coming online, 6 types of medications for in-home use to ease COVID symptoms are selling fast, with 3 months' worth of inventory sold in half a day. The second ruling of the long-running RCA industrial compensation case came out with over 1,000 plaintiffs awarded $1.66 billion, lower than the previous $2.3 billion. Conflicts broke out in the legislature over the amendment regarding the usage of state affairs funds, which the KMT accused of being politically motivated.
Kuomintang legislator Chen Yuzhen and Democratic Progressive Party legislator Wang Meihui got into a shoving match on the rostrum. The issue at stake was amendments to Article 99-1 of the Counting Act, which decriminalizes the usage of state affairs funds. The legislature's Finance Committee reviewed the amendments on April 21st, and parties mobilized their legislators to prepare for battle. The KMT said the DPP's motivation is to exonerate Chen Shui-bian. The new power party spoke out against the amendments. While the KMT began tossing fake money and fake gift certificates after the meeting started to mock Chen, it also asked for the meeting to be adjourned. The DPP managed to secure the rostrum and in the chaos, one of its legislators proposed ending the discussions and allowing the entire legislature to handle the matter. In the end, the DPP managed to use its majority to pass the first reading and adjourn the meeting at 9:13 a.m. The KMT continued to protest the illegality and unconstitutionality of the amendments, while the DPP insisted that special allowance funds and state affairs funds be treated the same and decriminalized so that the constitutional principle of equality won't be violated. Party caucuses will need to discuss a draft bill before it's sent to the entire legislature.
Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.